Hi friends, our next chapter is all about magnets and magnetism. Well, Earth behaves as a magnet with magnetic field pointing approximately from geographic south to the geographic north. You will understand why I said approximately by the end of this chapter probably. Okay, do you know what is a bar magnet? A bar magnet is nothing but a magnet in bar shape with the magnetic poles at its two ends. How to decide this? When you suspend this magnet freely, then the end which points to the geographic north of Earth is called as North Pole, and which points to the geographic south approximately is called as South Pole. Like poles repel and unlike poles attract each other. There is nothing to explain about it. Well, another property is that north and south poles of a magnet can't be isolated. If you have a bar magnet, you have North Pole here and South Pole here, okay? If you break this, what happens? You get two small pieces, but even these pieces have North and South Poles individually. Of course, the magnetic properties are weaker, but however, still, there are two poles in each piece. I mean to say that North and South Poles of magnet can't be isolated. The other way of saying it is that, magnetic monopoles do not exist. When you sprinkle some iron fillings over a magnet, then automatically they get arranged in this fashion. When you place a cardboard or some sheet over a magnet and sprinkle some iron fillings, then they get arranged in a similar fashion. This picture gives an idea about that. Well, these lines which you see here, these lines, they are nothing but magnetic field lines. In electrostatics, we had electric field and electric field lines, right? Similarly, we have magnetic field and magnetic field lines here. And these magnetic field lines have some definite properties. These field lines are continuous loops. You observe this? There are field lines even inside this magnet. Are you able to observe these lines? They are continuous loops. In electrostatics, we had just field lines, right? Just they come out of positive charge and go till infinity. Here, it's not the case. They are continuous loops. This is over. Tangent to the field line at a given point represents the direction of net magnetic field at that point. So here the magnetic field is in this direction and here it is in this direction and here it is in this direction. Okay, tangential. Hope everything is clear till now. And the large number of magnetic field lines crossing unit area implies stronger magnetic field. It just means that here there are more number of lines when compared to this region when I take same cross-sectional area. So it means that here the magnetic field is more when compared to this region. Okay, and magnetic field lines do not intersect. If they intersect at this point, at the point of intersection, we'll have two directions for magnetic field, which is observed. So magnetic field lines do not intersect. And note that they are coming out of North Pole and going into the South Pole. If you want to draw the field lines, either you can sprinkle iron fillings, or the other way is take a bar magnet and place a magnetic compass here. First, the needle will point in this direction. When you place it here, the needle will point in this direction. And similarly, when you change the locations, you'll observe that the needle changes its direction. And when you join all this, we finally get the magnetic field lines. You have a bar magnet here. You observe the field lines, right? They were something like this. And of course, this is north, this is south. This gives the direction. And when you observe a solenoid, if you pass electricity through it, if you pass current through it, even they give similar field lines. Of course, it's not an infinite solenoid. This is just a small one, okay? And so both are almost equivalent. If you cut a bar magnet, I said that you will get small, two small magnets of weaker properties. And it is the same case with solenoid also. And let's move forward. I said you that in some video, I don't remember exactly what it is, but I derived this formula for calculating magnetic field when you have a circular current carrying loop on its axis. I want to calculate at this point P say. Then my magnetic field will be mu naught I, where I is the current, and A square by 2 x square plus a square whole power 3 by 2. Do you remember this? Where a is this radius of circular loop and x is this distance from the center to the point P where I want to calculate the magnetic field. So this is the formula we have for calculating magnetic field when you have a circular current carrying loop. Okay. Now I want to use this formula for calculating the magnetic field due to a bar magnet. Okay. I'll do it. Here is the bar magnet, say, and this is origin, say, at the center of this bar magnet, and I have this axis. I want to calculate the magnetic field at this point P, which is at a distance r from the center of bar magnet, that is origin. And okay, first I'll do by integration method and take a small element, a circular loop, say, which is at a distance of x from the origin, and let this thickness be dx. Okay. Now I said that a bar magnet is equivalent to a solenoid. So solenoid is nothing but a collection of circular loops, right? But I know this formula for circular loop. So what I'll do, I'll assume that this bar magnet is nothing but a solenoid, and this circular element is nothing but a wire or collection of wires, it doesn't matter to me. And I'll use this formula. First of all, magnetic field at this point P due to only this element, this dx, this thickness, will be mu naught into what is the current here. If this is a solenoid of n turns per unit length, then my total number of turns will be n into dx, and the current will be I, say, and radius will be a only, take it a, and here I have 2 into, it's not x square, here it is r minus x, right, from this loop to this point, this distance, it is r minus x whole square plus a square whole power 3 by 2. Okay, this is my magnetic field due to only this part, this dx element. Okay, now what I'll do to get the total magnetic field, I'll just integrate this mu naught and I a square, these are constants, and I'll integrate it from minus L to plus L, where 2L is the length of bar magnet. So this should give me the answer. And don't worry, we are not going to solve this now. This can be solved using some trigonometric substitutions, but let us do something very simple. If R is very very greater than X and R is very very greater than A, I mean when we are looking at the bar magnet from very far distance, then what happens? I can approximate the denominator to r cube. So my final integral becomes mu naught n I a square by 2 r cube. And this is minus L to L dx, right? This is far simpler, right? And the final answer is mu naught n I 2 L a cube by 2 r cube. So this is the magnetic field point P due to bar magnet. Now, if we have a solenoid, actually, you know that the magnetic moment M of a solenoid is N into 2L into I a square, I pi a square. I'll tell you, magnetic moment is nothing but a current times area, right? Of course, it's a vector, but this is what? Simpler definition, okay? What is the current now? 2L is the length of bar magnet, n is the number of turns per unit length. So n times 2l gives me total number of turns, and when it's multiplied with current, that should give me the total current, and when it's multiplied with the area, that should give me the magnetic moment, right? So this is the magnetic moment of the solenoid, or in this case bar magnet, which I assumed it to be a solenoid. Okay, so the same B in this formula, this can be written as mu naught by 4 pi, just n power minus 7, and 2 m by r cube. Just I replace these terms with m, that's it. So this is your magnetic field. And observe one thing, some textbooks say that when you have a bar magnet, they say that North Pole is nothing but a magnetic monopole, or they say it's of magnetic charge Qm. And they say that the magnetic field is just given by mu naught by 4 pi and 2, that is constant times magnetic charge by r square. Of course, this appears to be far more simple, but this is not a correct approach because magnetic monopoles do not exist. So let us not get used to that. Let's move forward. If a magnetic dipole, that is nothing but a bar magnet, if it is placed in uniform magnetic field, uniform external magnetic field, say this is your dipole, that is bar magnet, north pole, south pole, okay. If this is your angle theta, then what? I want to calculate the potential energy difference here. First of all, what is torque? It is magnetic moment, and when it is crossed with the magnetic field, that is, this is vector product, okay. And you know that the potential energy is given by torque dot d theta, okay. Torque at theta, okay. And what is torque? M cross B, that is MB sine theta. MB sine theta. And here you have d theta. When I integrate this, I get minus B dot B minus MB cos theta, which is nothing but minus dot product of M and B. So this is the potential difference. This is the potential energy. And you may say that what about constant? I am free to choose it because I am more concerned about potential energy difference. So I am choosing it to be zero. I mean, here it is a convention. By taking constant is equal to zero, I mean that the potential energy at theta is equal to 90 is zero. That is the meaning of this convention, okay. And what does it mean? It means that when theta is equal to 0, you have potential energy as minus MB, which is the least. And when theta is equal to 180 degrees, you have potential energy as MB, which is the highest. So this is the most stable position and this is most unstable position. Hope everything is clear. Let's solve a problem quickly. A short bar magnet is placed with its axis at 30 degrees with external magnetic field. Okay, I have this magnetic field here and I placed a dipole, that is bar magnet, at 30 degrees. Say this is north and this is south. And it experiences a torque of 0.016 Newton meter. Magnetic field is given as 800 Gauss. That is nothing but 0.08 Tesla. Okay. What is the magnetic moment of this dipole? Okay, first, what is torque? Torque is given by MB sine theta, right? Now, torque is given as 0.016 and M I have to find it. B is given as 0.08 and sine theta is sine 30 1 by 2. So, from this equation, you can get M as 0.4 ampere meter square. Okay, this is solved. Now, what is the work done in moving it from its most stable to most unstable position? What is the most stable position? It is when theta is equal to 0 and potential energy at that stage is um is minus m dot b, right? And at most unstable stage it will be m dot b, that is when theta is equal to 180. So the difference of these two will be mb minus mb, that is nothing but 2 mb. You know the magnetic field, you know the magnetic moment, we have just calculated it now, it is 0.4. So from this you will get the answer as 0.064 joules. The bar magnet is replaced by a solenoid of cross sectional area 2 into 10 power minus 4 meter square and 1000 turns. Okay, and I want to replace the bar magnet with this solenoid. So what is the current that I should pass through the solenoid so that my magnetic moment isn't changed? So what is the magnetic moment of solenoid? It is NIA, current times area, and we have N loops, right? So it is NIA. And you know the magnetic moment, we have calculated it. It is 0.4 ampere meter square. So let's equate both. You get 0.4 is nothing but N 1000 into I into area is 2 into 10 power minus 4. So this gives you the current 2 ampere. So if you pass 2 ampere through the solenoid of given dimensions, You can replace it with the bar magnet of the problem. Keep watching. Bye.